Smartphones have changed our lives in so many ways, but they've also made it so that spam callers and robocalls can get a hold of us more easily. In this video, I'm going to show you all the methods that you can take to avoid and send those spam calls directly to your voicemail. Let's get into it. Okay, let's start with the most basic and then we'll get more advanced as we move along. So let's go ahead and let's tap on the phone app. And let's make sure we're in the recent section down at the bottom. And now we can find a number that we think is spam and we can tap on the I next to it. So this is a number that has already called us. So I'm just going to tap I on that number in the middle. And from here, you'll notice that down at the bottom, we have the option to block this caller. So when I tap on that, it says we're not going to receive phone calls, messages, or FaceTime from people on the block list. Great, that's exactly what we're looking for. So let's go ahead and let's block this particular contact. So that's the first method, and that can get annoying because oftentimes spam callers use different phone numbers because of this reason. So this doesn't really do that much. It means, hey, you can't just keep calling me with the same number, but if you're savvy enough to change your number every call using like a VOIP number that you can just change it on a computer, that's what they do, then they're still gonna get you. So what else can we do? Well, let's go back to our home screen and let's go to our settings. From within settings, let's scroll down to the phone section. There are a few iOS, iPhone settings that we can change, and there also might be some settings from your carrier. So let's tap on phone. And from here, you'll notice that we have a few sections down a little bit. The first one is silence unknown callers. And by default on iOS, this is actually turned off. So this might be one thing right away that you can do to help avoid spam calls. Now, this is only going to block those calls that when they show up on your phone, it says unknown. If it's a spam call, but it actually shows a phone number, this isn't going to block it. So do be aware of that. But let's go ahead and let's enable that feature. And then let's go back one and let's take a look at this call blocking and identification section. You'll notice that there's an option in here to silence junk callers. Now, this is turned on by default on most iOS devices, I believe, but it's certainly worth looking at and making sure that it's turned on. This is actually done through your carrier. So you'll notice that on mine, it says that calls identified by Verizon as potential spam will be blocked. So this does depend on who your carrier is. I don't know which ones are better than others, maybe AT&T, Verizon, some other carrier, maybe an international carrier, I don't know, but this does make it so that the carrier can block those calls for you. So those are all of the options that you have for blocking numbers on your iPhone. However, I dug a little bit deeper and I went and I looked at my carrier and I actually found some more options. So let's go ahead and move over to my computer and take a look. Okay, so here we are on the Verizon website, and I want to mention that I went into my Verizon account and I looked for ways to block spam calls and I didn't really find anything. However, I tried searching Google. As you can see, I searched ways to block spam calls Verizon. And this second link actually gave me a few great options. So don't just go into your carrier's website and look through there, actually do a Google search. So if it's AT&T or another carrier, search for it in Google because that's how I found it with Verizon. So this is the website that I found. You'll notice that it says they offer caller ID and spam alerts for home phones. That doesn't help us. They also recommend registering phone numbers at DONotCall.gov. So I've done this with my physical mailing address. I register with all of those services that try and take you off all the junk mail lists, but I haven't done this with my phone, and I think this is something that I'm going to do, and I think it's a great option that you should try as well. So you can go to DONotCall.gov and register your phone number. This takes you off all of the legal spam call lists, not necessarily the illegal ones. However, additionally, there's another option here on Verizon, and you'll notice that it says for wireless customers, they have this thing called Verizon's call filter, and it can help you avoid unwanted calls. So I clicked on that, and I started to take a look, and I just clicked on Get It Now. You know, I'm logged into my Verizon account. You'll notice that it says Enroll in Call Filter, and it's free, and earlier today, my devices weren't enrolled in this. I just enrolled them. I've been using Verizon for years. I do get spam calls, not that much. I guess I've gotten used to just hitting silence and ignoring them. But I was very surprised to find that I wasn't using Verizon's additional service for blocking spam calls. So I really recommend that you check with your carrier. Again, I showed you all of the ways that you can do it on an actual iPhone, but there may be some additional things you can do with your carrier. So definitely look into that. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. And if you want to see more technology tips and tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's all I have for you for now. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.